Hello everybody, today I'm going to show you how to install a couple different files that we use for docking. So if you want to click the first link in the description, it's going to take you to Pymol's website. You can fill out this information here. So I am a student, teacher, first name, last name, email, phone number, etc. And once you do that, hit continue. And what they'll do is they're going to send you an email, and on that email is going to have the login credentials as well as a link to click. And that will take you to the website that offers the download files of Pymol. Alrighty, so once you receive that email, if you scroll to the bottom of it, at the bottom of that email, you'll see a link and you'll see a username and a password. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on this link. And once you've clicked that link, it's going to take you to this website, and it's going to ask you to sign in with your username and password that they provide you. Now, after you've entered in the username and password, you should see these links. First thing we're going to click is this Pymol-edu license file. Right there. And we're going to use that later, so hold on to that. And then lastly, we're going to go to the installers page. And we are going to click the Windows EXE installer. And once that's done downloading, we'll go to the next step. Alright, so once that is finished installing, we can click on the .exe file right here. And what this is going to do is pop up the installer window, we hit next, I agree. You can do all users if you want to, depending on the setup you have. Most people just have one user on their computer, just depends. When we hit next, you won't be able to see this, but it's asking if I want to allow this application to make changes to my device. Just choose yes. And then it's going to ask you for an install location. You can just keep it in the default location. It won't be an issue. Hit next. And what we're going to do is we're going to hit yes on all of these. Sorry, yes on this, not on that. And then once this is done installing, we'll go on to the next stage. All right, now that it is done installing, we can hit the next button and finish. And that's actually all we have to do, and we can find Pymol just by searching it here, Pymol. We actually have one last little step to do, and that's to license Pymol. Now, my version of Pymol is already licensed, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna search for Pymol. And on yours, it's gonna pop up and say, activation required. Hit browse for license, and then when you hit browse, go to your downloads and use that license file that you downloaded. All right, and that actually concludes the installation of Pymol. It should be licensed and ready to use. All right, so now on to the next program. So if you click the second link in the description, it'll bring you to this page. We're going to install MGL Tools. Now, MGL Tools contains Autodock Tools, which is specifically the most useful one to us. But for our purposes, we're just going to install the whole suite. So from this page for Windows, we're going to click MGL Tools Win32 1.5.6 setup.exe. So click that. All right. Now, I already have this downloaded, so I'm not going to make you sit through that. Now, something important, if you click the .exe file, so as soon as this is done downloading, if you on your computer just click this to start running it, it probably won't work properly. That's because it doesn't have the correct privileges on your system in order to install everything. So what we're going to do instead is you're going to go to your downloads folder, you're going to right click, run as administrator. Now, you won't be able to see my screen once it pops up, but it's going to ask if you want to allow this application to make changes on your device. Just choose yes. And then we're going to hit next. I accept the terms of the license agreement. Yes. We can leave it in the default destination folder unless you have a specific reason to change it. It's fine there. Hit next. And it's going to install. So we're going to let that do its thing, and we'll go back when it's done. Alright, so as soon as our installation is done, you're going to see this message pop up that says the software component is made for non-commercial use, which is fine. We hit OK. It's going to give us an installation complete message. It has the option to launch PMV, create desktop shortcut, create quick launch shortcut as well. We can just unclick launch PMV. We don't need to do that right now, and hit finish. Fantastic. So if we go back to our desktop, we should see that we should have PMV, Autodock Tools, and all of these different parts of the suite. Now what we can do is we can just move these over into our recycle bin. Unless you specifically need these programs, the main program we're going to need is Autodock Tools. So leave that there. So that actually concludes the installation of Autodock Tools, and then right now we'll go on to our next one. So the next program we're going to install is called Autodock Vina. Now this actually works with Autodock Tools in order to perform the docking, as well as give us some information about what occurs when we do that. So if you want to click the link in the description that I have below and click Windows, this is going to be the version for us, Autodock Vina 112win32.msi. So click that. Now before we start initiating the installation folder, we're first going to make sure we have something on our desktop. So if you want to go to your desktop, just right click new folder and rename that folder Vina. This is going to make it easier for us later, and you'll see why here soon. So I'm going to go back to my browser and click my Autodock Vina installation file. It's going to start launching that. Now, unlike the MGL Tools download, we don't need to run this as an administrator. It won't have any issues when we try to run this. So hit next. I agree. Next. So where it says select installation folder, you can leave it here if that's your preference, but I think it's far more easier if we hit browse. We're going to go back here to our local disk, users. Now I'm on a family profile here, so I'm going to click family, desktop, and then Vina. Okay. So you can see it's in this user, this is a shared account, a desktop, Vina. So that's going to install it in that folder that we said earlier. We're going to hit next, and then next to start installation. Now you can't see this pop up once again, but it's asking me if I want to allow it to make changes to my computer. Just hit yes. And then it should bring up a message that says Vina has been successfully installed. So we can hit close to exit. And now if we go to our desktop in the Vina folder, you can see we have all the different files that we need. So that works out great. So that's actually going to conclude our installation of Vina, and we'll move on to the next program. All right, so the next program we're going to install is called PDB Tools. Now, if you have Python already installed, you can skip what I'm about to show you into the timestamp in the description. I'll have that linked in there. But if not, if you click the link in the description for Python, we can install that real quick. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and click that link, and it should automatically detect which version of an operating system you're on. So in this case, it's detecting Windows, and you can just hit the download button. If for some reason it's not detecting that you're on Windows, you can just go over to Downloads and then click Windows and download it that way. And then when you're ready, just click that. Now I already have this downloaded, so we'll go ahead and just click the installer, and it's going to ask you if you want to install now. Before you do that, add Python to path. It's just going to make it easier to use different Python commands, and then we can hit install now. Alright, so when we're done, you can see here it'll bring up some other options. You don't have to disable path length limit if you don't want to, and just hit close. Alright, so now in order to check to make sure that we've got Python installed, we can go to our little explorer here and type in cmd, command prompt, and then we can type in Python, and it should give us our version of Python, so you can see that it correctly installed Python 3.7.2, so we're good to go. Now another thing we need to make sure we have is pip. Now pip is a program that should come bundled in with Python, and it essentially is an installer. So what we're going to do real quick is type in pip and verify that we have it. So you can see we do have pip installed. If for whatever reason you do not have pip installed, you can very, very easily get it on Windows by in your command prompt typing in easy underscore install pip. What that does is it searches for pip and go ahead and it installs it. So it's already installed, so it doesn't really need to do anything else for me, but it should be good to go. Alright, now once you have verified that pip is installed successfully, now you can install PDB Tools. The way you'll accomplish this is by typing in pip install PDB-tools. Make sure that's spelled correctly. Hit enter. What it will do is it'll go through, check to make sure it's got it, and then it'll start installing it. So you can see my pip version might be out of date. That's not necessarily important. The important part is this line here that says successfully installed PDB tools. So now in order to check and make sure that we've got PDB tools installed, we can use a test command. So PDB underscore fetch. So this is one of the many scripts available from PDB tools. I will link below some of the most useful commands. And what this command does is fetch a PDB structure. So let's say that we make a new folder called docking, and I want to use PDB tools to fetch a PDB. So all I have to do is change my directory. So cd desktop / docking. Oops. All right, so now I'm in this folder. And now PDB tools can be used in this folder, PDB underscore fetch. So let's say I fetch PPAR, which this is a PDB ID for PPAR gamma. And then you do a little mark like that, a little arrow forward, and then say the name you want to give it, which I'll name it PPAR.PDB. Make sure you do the PDB extension, hit enter. So now if we check in our docking folder, we have a PDB file called PPAR. So this is incredibly useful. Just keep in mind, you have to be in the directory with the folder, with the files you want to work on while you're using this. But if I wanted to select just a single chain from PPAR, I could do PDB underscore select chain or cell chain dash A. And then I list the PDB I want to select, the arrow, and what I will rename it. So PPAR underscore A dot PDB is what I'll rename it. And now if I look here, I've got PPAR with just the A, and you can see it's a smaller file size accordingly, so because it only has chain A in it. And if you ever have any questions about how to use the tool itself, if you type in the name of it, so PDB cell chain for instance, it'll give you instructions on how to use it. So that actually concludes our tutorials of how to install some software for docking. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments down below, and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you.